Hello, my name is Andre Pombo, and I'm here to talk about the role of motor competence in lifespan healthy habits. So I'd like to start this presentation by giving the definition of motor competence and its importance on development of the children. Motor competence is a person's ability to be proficient on a variety of motor skills. Postural, like dynamic and static balance, locomotor, running or jumping, and manipulative, like throwing, catching or kicking. But this is not a static process. Children change the way they move accordingly to the level of maturation. To better understand these changes, I would like to show you the model proposed by David Galloway that tells us, or that brings us, the idea that motor development is divided by phases. And these phases give the children an accumulated experience that can be used on their daily life, recreation, or even competition. So motor competence sets the foundation of movement for the children to learn more complex movement that can be used in sports later. These models take us to another model developed by Stodden and its colleagues in 2008. This model gives us the idea that motor competence can influence lifelong habits. Children in this model can take two paths. One of positive spiral of engagement, and another one, a negative one, that negative spiral of disengagement. In our studies, we focus, and given the society that we live in, on the lower part of this model. And what does that lower part tell us? It tells us that low levels of motor competence, low levels of perceived motor competence, foster low levels of fitness and physical activity. And all of this take us to a bigger risk of unhealthy habits, and unhealthy weight. So now we wanted to understand how this negative spiral could influence the motor competence. What influence does motor competence has on health markers? But what health markers would we choose? So we would like to study a lot of them. So we choose the metabolic syndrome because it's a cluster of risk factors obesity related. In children, metabolic syndrome, it's not consensuous, the definition, it's not consensuous. So we made a composed value of metabolic syndrome to study the children. We included cholesterol, hypertension, abdominal obesity, fasting glucose, and low density lipoprotein-cholesterol. As for the motor competence, we use the motor competence assessment that was developed in this very lab by Carlos Luz, Luis Paulo Rodrigues, Gabriel Almeida and Rita Cordeville. This battery is composed by 6 tests, 2 stability ones, shifting platforms and sideways jump, 2 locomotor, shuttle run and longitudinal jump, and 2 manipulative tests, throwing and kicking. But we couldn't evaluate only the motor competence. We had to see if fitness influence our results. So we did the pacer test and the handgrip test. We went to the school, to a Lisbon school, and evaluated the children in these variables. And the results that we found were very interesting. So we found that muscular strength and motor competence could be predictors of the metabolic syndrome. And our model could explain 38% of the variation of the metabolic syndrome. So now we had a confirmation and indicator that motor competence can influence healthy markers or health markers. So now we needed to see if an intervention in motor competence could influence our health markers. But COVID showed up. I don't know if you were aware of this, but it was a pandemic that sent all of us home, including children that was the ones that suffered the most. So we could see this as a failure to our study or as an opportunity. So we think of this like this is an opportunity. We can study this as a quasi-experimental study to see what are the impact of a totally movement restriction has in motor competence in children. So what did this do to our children? Well, we were expecting lower we were expecting bad results, but we weren't expecting the magnitude of these results. We took 114 children that we evaluated before the lockdown, and as the school opened, we re-evaluate them in the motor competence. So what did we found out? We found out that the motor competence decreased in all the children. Not only a decrease in all the children, the results were worst post-lockdown in every test except side jumps, and that boys decreased 13 points and girls decreased 16 points on motor competence. Now what? We had the confirmation that the motor competence has an influence on health markers. We have the confirmation that children decrease the motor competence in the lockdown situation. So now we are in a darker place. So Portugal already has an overweight prevalence of 30% and an obesity prevalence of 12%. We lost a lot of athletes during the lockdown, in the first lockdown, so probably we lost even more in the second lockdown. So now we need to think about what strategies can we implement to bring the kids back to sports and back to movement, to play outside, to play sports, to do physical activity. Or else we are in the dark place where the predictions of the European Committee will come through. We are seeing predictions that our life expectancy will reduce, that our governments will spend a lot of money in diseases that are obesity related, and if we don't change that now, we are having a future pretty dark. So it's fundamental to think of activities, to think of strategies to bring kids back to movement, to sports, and to physical activity. Thanks so much for your attention.